Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to fix common problems that you might be having with page numbers in InDesign. And if you don't know how to add page numbers, there will be a video right up here at the top of your screen that shows you how. So there are really three common things I see with page numbers. First, your page number is falling behind a photo on a page, so it doesn't show up at all. Second is getting a page number to start on any page you want, which might not be the first pages of your document. And third is page numbers not showing up on some pages that you want them to show up on, or they are showing up on pages that you don't want them to show up on. So I'll show you how to fix these three things. All right, let's get started. Okay, so the first problem I see is page numbers falling behind a photo or behind like a color block. And this is something that's happening actually on these first two pages. There are numbers under here, but you can't see them because there's a color block underneath it. So to fix this problem, we'll come over here to the layers, and I'm just going to create a new layer. I'll make sure I'm clicked on that. And then I'll come back to my pages and go to my A master and double click this page. Now here's my page number here. I'll select it. I'm going to click and drag from this square to this square, and that puts it on the other layer. So now the page number is up here and all the document content is down here on layer one. So if we click back on our document, you can see our page numbers on top like they should be. Now we have a new problem that's happening now, and that is that this page number is not showing up very well because it's dark on a dark background. So to fix this, I'm going to make a new master page. So I'll just duplicate this one. And now we have a B parent. I'll double click that, and I'm just going to change the color of my page number here to white. So I'll get in my swatches. We'll just make it paper. Now I can come back to my first page. And as you can see, it has a little A right up here to show it's pulling from the A master. So we need it to pull from the B parent. Actually, the master pages have changed to parent pages now, so I should always say parent pages, but I'm so used to saying master pages, so sorry about that. I'm going to right click here, and I'm going to choose apply parent to pages, and I'll choose B parent and say OK. Now you can see this page number one has a white page number, and all the other pages have a dark page number. I think we're going to run into that same problem over here, so I'll do the same thing there. Right click and choose apply parent to pages, and we'll choose our B parent and say okay. So that's sort of two problems in one, really. Second is how to get your page numbers to start on any page instead of page one right here. For example, this is more like a title page, and I wouldn't want number one to start here. So to do this, we'll want to go to the page we do want the numbers to start at. I'm going to go to page three because this is also like a chapter page. I'm going to right click on page three, and you'll see you have allow document pages to shuffle checked and also allow selected spread to shuffle. We need to uncheck both of these, so we'll do that. And then the next step is to right click again and choose numbering and section options. And basically we're going to start a new section on page three. So to do that, I'm going to choose start page numbering at one on page three. So we'll say okay. It's going to give us kind of an error message, but that's okay. So we'll say okay. Now, if we scroll down to page three, you can see it starts at number one. Now we also have these two page numbers up here, and this is actually the third problem that we want to take care of today, and that is getting page numbers to not be on some pages. So to do that, I'm just going to pull none right down here on page one and also on page two. So now we have no parent page applied to page one and two, and our new section starts at page three, which is page number one. And they continue on from there. So that's what to do if you don't want a page number to show up. Now, if you want a different style of page number on a different page, all you have to do is make a new parent for that page and then pull that onto your current page, or right click that page and choose apply parent to pages. All right, I hope you liked this video. If you did, please click on the like button, and I'll see you next week with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.